INSET 2021 likely question topic, indices in forensic medicine, right? Indices in forensic medicine, right? I've designed this session in such a way that it will have two sessions, today and tomorrow. In these two sessions, I'll cover all the indices with respect to forensic medicine, right? All the indexes, ratios and all, right? One of the most important topics. At the outset, you should know two terminologies. One is morphometry, right? Morphometry is measurement of dimensions, right? Any dimension. So morphometry is common to all species, all animals, right? It is common to human as well as animals. Morphometry. So morpho means measurement of dimensions, right? Dimension. Other terminology is anthropometry, right? Anthropometry. See, anthropometry is measurement of proportions of human body, right? Proportion of human body. So anthropometry means proportion with respect to body, right? Proportion with respect to body. See, one such anthropometric technique that is widely known to us is Bertillon system. Now, this Bertillon system is a Gipmer question. The Gipmer question is, which of the following techniques is an anthropometric technique, right? The answer is Bertillon system of anthropometry. So I'll tell you again, morphometry, dimension. Right? Measurement of dimension, morphometry. Now, anthropometry is measurement of proportion, body proportion, right? Body proportion. So, example is Bertillon system, yes. So, applications of morphometry. See, again, with the help of morphometry, what can we find? See, only three options are there, so you have to be careful. We can find species. See, you have a bone, or you have a body. See, with the body, you measure a proportion, or with a skeleton, you measure a proportion. This is morphometry. So with the morphometry, what can we achieve? With the help of morphometry, we can find species. We can find race, right? Or ethnicity, right? Nowadays, the word ethnicity is used. Older textbooks will say race. So remember, species, race, or ethnicity. And third one is sex of an individual, right? Sex of an individual. Only three. So these three means you have to be very careful, a very potential for being asked in an MCQ. So species, race and then sex, right? Yes, applications of morphometry, right? So indices to find race, indices to find race. So now there was a question 2 years back with respect to AIIMS. The question is, which of the following index is not useful to find race, right? The question is, which of the following index is not useful for finding race? That is the question. So now we'll come back to the slide. I'll tell you what are all the indices or index useful to find race of a particular individual. So one is cephalic index. The most important is cephalic index. We'll see in detail about it. The cephalic index, facial index, brachial index, crural index, intermembral index, humerofemoral index. Just remember the words. Cephalic, facial, then brachial, crural, intermembral, humerofemoral, right? See, only six to find race, only six. So cephalic, facial, brachial, crural, intermembral, and humerofemoral index. So we'll see one by one, all right? So first is cephalic index, right? Cephalic index, also called as Ritzius index. Now one MCQ was, which are the following is called Ritzius index, right? So easy, straightforward question. If we are so lucky or fortunate, we have the straightforward question. Another name for cephalic index is Ritzius index, right? Ritzius index, right? So the index takes into account, the numerator is maximal breadth of the skull. So maximal breadth, right? So the numerator is breadth. Hence, cephalic index is also called as breadth index of skull, right? Breadth index of skull. So cephalic index, Ritzius index, or breadth index of skull. Now, maximal breadth of the skull divided by maximal length of the skull. The formula is maximal breadth divided by maximal length into 100. So please remember this into 100. I'll tell you there is one more MCQ. That is, which of the following indices doesn't use the multiplication factor 100? Now, that was one MCQ, right? 3 years back. Which of the following indices doesn't use the multiplication factor 100, right? So today I am going to tell you the indices that use multiplication factor 100, right? It is easy to remember, right? So coming back to cephalic index, maximal breadth by maximal length into 100, So the first is if the value is between 70 to 75, 70 to 75, the skull is called dolichocephalic skull, right? Dolichocephalic skull, dolicho, right? Now, if the number is between 75 to 80, it is mesaticephalic. And if the number is 80 to 85, 80 to 85, it is brachycephalic. See, just understand the logic. Maximal breadth is the numerator. Maximal length of the skull is the denominator. So as long as the skull is shorter, brachy means short, right? Brachy means short. If the length is decreased, number, the value, the cephalic index will be higher, 80 to 85, higher value. So brachycephalic, right? Brachycephalic. So I'll tell you again, 70 to 75 dolichocephalic, 75 to 80 mesaticephalic, 80 to 85 brachycephalic. Now, the question here is, so these dolichocephalic, mesaticephalic, or brachycephalic would fit into which race, right? Which race? Now, answer is D. Remember, D is for Dravidians, Aryans, Negroids, right? Dolichocephalic fit into Dravidians, pure Aryans, and Negroids, right? Yes. Then mesaticephalic fits into Chinese, right? Chinese. Mesaticephalic, Chinese. Then brachycephalic is Mongols and Japanese. So I'll tell you again, dolichocephalic belongs to Dravidians, Aryans, Negroids. We can say aborigines, aborigines also, natives, aborigines, right? Then mesaticephalic for Chinese, brachycephalic for Mongols and Japanese. So please remember, cephalic index is often repeated MCQ with respect to INSET, often repeated MCQ, right? Cephalic index, also called as Ritzius index or breadth index. The value is 70 to 75, dolichocephalic, Dravidian, aborigine, Aryan, Negroid. If the value is 75 to 80, mesaticephalic, Chinese. The value is 80 to 85, brachycephalic, Mongols or Japanese, right? So in this slide, so just know the formula. Number is not mandatory for this index. Number is asked only for cephalic index. Other indices, just know the formula. That is enough, right? So second index to find raises facial index. Facial index, right? Facial index. See, facial index is nothing but the distance between nasion to gnathion, right? Chin, nasion to gnathion. So the maximal distance between nasion to gnathion, numerator. And the denominator is zygomatic distance, right? Maximal facial width. This other is called as maximal facial width, right? So the numerator is the distance between nasion to gnathion, and the denominator is zygomatic distance, right? Zygomatic distance, yes. So other indices to find rays, right? So first is cephalic index, second is facial index. Now other four indices are brachial index, crural index, intermembranal index, humerofemoral index. So now, how do we calculate brachial index? Brachial index is nothing but, just look at the word brachial, R comes first. Remember this way, R comes first in brachial, BR. So R, right? R comes first. Length of radius, maximal length of radius divided by maximal length of humerus, right? Into 100, right? Into 100. See, all indices to find rays have multiplication factor 100, right? All six indices to find rays will have multiplication factor 100, right? So brachial index is maximal length of radius divided by maximal length of humerus into 100, right? So if you remember this, you can fill the next. Crural index is maximal length of tibia divided by maximal length of femur, right? So maximal length of tibia divided by maximal length of femur. Now, third one, intermembranal index. Intermembranal index is nothing but you have to add radius and humerus in the numerator. Maximal length of radius with maximal length of humerus in the numerator. The denominator has maximal length of tibia plus femur, right? Maximal length of tibia plus femur into 100, right? Intermembranal index. And humerofemoral index is so easy. Length of humerus divided by length of femur, right? Length of humerus divided by length of femur into 100. So shortly, the animation, please. So I have made a box here. Brachial index, R by H. Maximal length of radius by humerus. Crural index, tibia by femur. Intermembranal index is, you have to add radius plus humerus divided by tibia plus femur. Now, humerofemoral index is nothing but length of humerus divided by length of femur. Yes. So you can see the box, right? Please remember, I'll tell you again, brachial index, first R comes with respect to the word brachium, R comes first. So radius comes to the numerator, right? Then humerus. So if you remember one thing, you can deduce the other things, tibia by femur, right? For brachial and choral index, right? Intermembranal index is easy. You have to add, it is nothing but ratio of upper limb to lower limb. You can remember this way, ratio of upper limb to lower limb, right? Tentatively, you can remember that way. So you have to add radius plus humerus and then divide by tibia plus femur, right? Yes. Then humerofemoral index, I told you. So out these four indices, it is enough if we know what is the numerator and denominator, right? Okay. So other, see, these are not indexes. I'll tell you, these are not indices, but they are often repeated MCQ with respect to race. With respect to race, they are often repeated MCQ, right? If you see the word nasal gutter, see, the question will be in such a way that a skull was recovered from a deserted area. The skull has so-and-so cephalic index with the following features, right? If you see the word nasal gutter, the race is negroid. Straight away you can say nasal gutter negroid, right? Nasal gutter is unique to negroid race. Please remember, nasal gutter, right? One clinching point for negroid race is nasal gutter, right? Nasal gutter, right? So the nasal cavity will be, if you take the skull in the nasal area, there will be a gutter-like trait, right? Gutter-like trait. Gutter is nothing but a drainage pathway, right? It is called pathway. So gutter will be a huge pathway like a dip in the nasal area. So nasal gutter, negroid, right? A negroid. So additional features will be hyperbolic dental arch and a rectangle orbit, right? Rectangle orbit for negroid, right? So for Mongols, shovel incisors, right? I'll show you the photo. You would understand. Then elliptical dental arch, right? Elliptical dental arch, right? And third one is coccocyte. See, remember coccocyte C for carabellicus C. So carabellicus, right? Carabellicus is present in coccocyte race. Often repeated MCQ, carabellicus is seen in coccocyte race. Nasal gutter, negroid. Shovel incisor, Mongol. Right, often repeated MCQ, straightforward questions, so easy, right? Straightforward questions, so easy. So I've given the shape of dental arch, right, in the animation form, you can see it. So I tell you again, carabellicus, coccosi, never forget, shovel incisor, Mongol, nasal gutter, negroid. Yes, you see, this is a shovel used for digging, right? Digging, the shovel on the right side. Now the incisor, if you look at the incisor, the inside surface, right, the inside surface will look exactly like the shovel, right? Exactly like the shovel. It is called shovel-shaped incisor, right? Shovel-shaped incisor. Now, there is a different question, a different wording, you can say. In PGI, there was a question, double shovel incisor. See, shovel-shaped incisor, we know, right? Double shovel-shaped incisor, the same thing, nothing but the shovel shape will be present even on the anterior aspect also. Now, what we are saying is posterior aspect of the incisor. The posterior aspect, see, the shovel shaping is more common in posterior aspect. We can see shoveling only on the posterior aspect of incisor teeth. If it is rarely seen on the anterior aspect also, it is called double shovel shaped incisor, right? So shovel shaped incisor, Mongol, right? So shovel shaped incisor, Mongol, right? Indices to find sex. So far we have completed indices to find race, right? Indices to find race. I tell you again, cephalic index was there, facial index was there, right? Brachial, crural, intermembral, humerofemoral. Six indices were there. So we saw six indices. Now we are going to the second application. Second application is to find sex of an individual. So we'll see first three, right? We'll see only the first three alone today. The remaining and the miscellaneous indices we'll see tomorrow, right? So first three, we'll concentrate only on the three. Most important and most repeat MCQs in the first three, we'll see that. So chirotic index, sciatic notch index, ischiopubic index, right? So we can remember with the mnemonic CSI, Church of South India, CSI, chirotic line, right? Sciatic notch, ischiopubic, CSI, right? CSI, as of now. So we'll see the first three, chirotic line, sciatic notch, ischiopubic indices, right? So the next slide, please. And the next slide, yes. So we have all three indices here. So I'll tell you one by one. The pictures clearly indicate, see the blue background picture, the chiotic line index. See, the chiotic line index is nothing but maximal length of pelvic segment of chiotic line divided by sacral segment of chiotic line. See, please follow me. Chiotic line index is nothing but you have to measure the chiotic line. So now, where is the chiotic line? The chiotic line indicated by the black line. You see, the black line is the chiotic line. See, chiotic line is nothing but an extension of iliopectineal eminence. So from iliopectineal eminence and from the iliopectineal line, you have to draw a line. So there is an anatomical ridge. It is nothing but an anatomical ridge. It is an anatomical ridge. No imaginary line. It is an anatomical ridge. So there is a chiotic line. So from the continuation of iliopectineal line. So you have to start from the iliopectineal eminence. So the line with the black line is the pelvic segment of chiotic line. So first is pelvic segment of chiotic line in the numerator. So if you draw the pelvic chiotic line, the chiotic line starts from iliopectineal eminence and it ends in auricle, right? This is the pelvic segment. Now from the auricle, extend the line to iliac crest. Extend the line to iliac crest, right? So chiotic line, extension of iliopectineal line, we know from iliopectineal eminence to auricle, that is pelvic segment of chiotic line. Second is from the auricle, extend the line to iliac crest, right? Iliac crest. See, you have to remember pelvic segment by sacral segment of chiotic line, where it starts, where it ends, right? Pelvic segment starts from iliopectineal eminence to auricle. Sacral segment starts from auricle to iliac crest, right? So this is chiotic line index, right? Now we'll go to sciatic notch index. See, sciatic notch index is nothing but D. It starts with D. Depth of sciatic notch. See, depth of sciatic notch divided by maximal breadth of sciatic notch, right? Maximal depth divided by maximal breadth, right? Sciatic notch index. So maximal depth divided by maximal breadth of sciatic notch into 100, of course, right? Yes. Chiotic line index, sciatic notch index, and ischiopubic index will have multiplication factor 100, right? Yes. And then last one is ischiopubic index, right? Ischiopubic index. Please remember, this ischiopubic index is otherwise called as Washburn index, right? Washburn index. Name of the anthropologist, Washburn. So ischiopubic index is length of pubis divided by length of ischium, right? Length of pubic bone by length of ischium bone into 100, right? Into 100. I'll tell you one important point with respect to ischiopubic index. Ischiopubic index is used to find sex of an individual even in utero, even in fetus. You can find sex using ischiopubic index. One. Second is, ischiopubic index is useful to identify species, right? Ischiopubic index is so unique in anthropology because ischiopubic index is used to find sex. That is the primary objective, ischiopubic index to find sex. Additional is, with respect to ischiopubic index, you can find species also. So chiotic line index, sciatic notch index, and ischiopubic index, all three will have a multiplication factor 100. All right, so with this we'll close today, and tomorrow we'll complete the indices for sex and other miscellaneous indexes with respect to forensic medicine. Right, thank you.
Best training, peaceful environment, PG medical entrance exam preparation were my expectations. I got them at Speed Medical Village in Kanchipuram. Today, I am a PG topper.
Speed Medical Village, a unique eco-friendly campus dedicated for PG preparation. Speed Medical Institute, a complete solution for medical education.